Mercedes-Benz is all set to bring in their first fully electric offering in the Indian market, the EQC 400. Ahead of its launch, the Mercedes-Benz EQC 400 electric SUV has been listed on the company's official website, indicating that its launch will take place in the coming weeks or months. The Mercedes-Benz EQC SUV was expected to go on sale in the Indian market earlier this year. However, amid the COVID-19 pandemic and the resulting lockdown, the plans had to be indefinitely delayed. We now expect the EQC 400 to launch in India sometime later this year. The website also has a small teaser video of the upcoming all-electric Mercedes-Benz SUV. The teaser showcases the EQC badging, LED headlamps, LED taillights, and a few other interiors features and equipment expected on the luxury electric SUV. Some of these expected features and equipment on the interiors include dual 10.3-inch displays, one for the infotainment and the other being the instrument cluster. The infotainment setup will come with the brand's latest iteration MBUX system, among a host of other comfort and convenience features as well. Powering the upcoming Mercedes-Benz EQC 400 SUV will be an 80 kW battery pack mated to two electric motors, one at each axle. The electric powertrain is said to be produced 405 bhp of power and 765 nm of peak torque and a claimed driving range of 400 km on a single charge. With an electric motor on each axle, the Mercedes-Benz EQC will essentially have a four-wheel drive system. The Mercedes-Benz EQC will come with a top speed limited to 180 km per hour, while a 0-100 km per hour sprint can be completed in 5.1 seconds. The EQC will come with both regular and fast charging options as standard. The fast charger will be capable of charging the electric SUV from 0 to 80% in just 40 minutes. The Mercedes-Benz EQC is just one of the many vehicles planned by the brand for the Indian market in the coming months. The German brand introduced an aggressive sales strategy for 2020, which saw multiple products like the new GLC, GLE, GLS and the AMG GTR being introduced in the Indian market. The company is also working on introducing the A-Class sedan in the country as well. What are your thoughts about this upcoming electric SUV by Mercedes-Benz? Do let us know in the comments section. Piaggio has launched the special edition Vespa Racing 60 scooter in the Indian market. The new Vespa Racing 60 scooter is a special limited edition model and is available in both 125cc and 150cc versions. The two variants are priced at Rs. 1.20 lakh and Rs. 1.32 lakh respectively. All prices are ex-showroom Delhi. The Vespa Racing 60s are based on the India's standard SXL 125 and SXL 150 models. The special edition scooter was first showcased in India back at the 2020 Auto Expo and was initially planned for an earlier launch. With the scooters now on sale, interested customers can book the scooter either through any of the brand's dealerships or online or an amount of Rs. 1000. Customers who book the scooter online will be eligible for benefits of up to Rs. 2000. The scooter is offered with an overall white paint scheme along with centrally running dual racing stripes on the front apron, fenders and at the rear. The red accents are also available on the side body panels as well. The Vespa Racing 60 scooter, as the name suggests, takes inspiration to its racing heritage of the 1960s. The scooter carries forward the livery of the old, giving the new scooter a classic styling with a sporty twist. Design details also include a host of blacked out elements. This includes the matte finish surrounding elements, rear view mirrors, surrounds for the front and the rear lights, grab handle footrest and the seat upholstery. The scooter also comes with a 5-spoke petal alloy wheels finished in a gold paint scheme, adding to the richness of the scooter. The Vespa Racing 60 scooter also comes with a host of mechanical equipment and other comfort features as well. This includes a monocoque full steel body, twin pod calipers with disc brakes, supported by anti-lock braking system or combi braking system depending on the variant. The special edition scooters also come with crystal illumination LED headlamps, central LED DRLs, USB charging port, boot light and a host of other features as well. The entry-level Vespa Racing 60's 125 scooter is powered by the brand's BS6 compliant fuel-injected 124cc single-cylinder engine. It produces 9.8 bhp at 7000 rpm and 9.6 nm of peak torque at 5500 rpm. The range-topping Vespa Racing 60's 150 variant is powered by a slightly more powerful 149cc single-cylinder fuel-injected engine. This produces 10.4 bhp at 7600 rpm and 10.30 nm of peak torque at 5500 rpm. Both variants have their engines mated to a CVT gearbox as standard. The Vespa Racing 60s is a special edition scooter offering which pays homage to the brand's racing heritage.
On
Honda Cars India has relaunched the fourth generation city in the country. The old gen sedan will be offered in two variants, SVMT and VMT. Prices for the fourth generation city start at Rs 9.29 lakh ex-showroom Delhi. The old gen sedan will be sold as a petrol-only model along with transmission option restricted to manual. The top spec VMT variant retails at Rs 9.99 lakh ex-showroom Delhi. Honda has reduced the price of both trims by around Rs 60,000 and Rs 66,000 on the SV and V trims respectively. Old Gen City is currently powered by a SOHC petrol engine that produces a maximum of 118 bhp at 6600 rpm and a peak torque of 145 Nm at 4600 rpm. The engine comes mated to either a 5-speed manual transmission as standard. Apart from that, the old Gen sedan comes decently equipped with a touchscreen infotainment system that supports Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Other features include a sunroof, a multifunction steering wheel, climate control, an engine start-stop button, multiple airbags, ABS with EBD and a rear parking camera, among others. According to the company, the 4th generation Honda City has cumulatively sold over 3.5 lakh units since its launch in January 2014 in India. With the old Gen City on sale, the company states that it has made affordable for sedan buyers in the country. The company will continue to sell the old Gen model alongside with the new 5th Gen City sedan. The 5th generation Honda City has been well received and retails between Rs 10.90 lakh to Rs 14.65 lakh. In comparison, the price difference between the entry-level variant of both models is around Rs 1.6 lakh. While the top spec trim of the old Gen City manages to under the entry-level spec of the new City by Rs 90,000. The older generation Honda City has been the brand's best seller. The automaker has decided to continue offering the old gen sedan and make it easily accessible to buyers switching from smaller cars. Yulu Electric Bike Service has been launched in Mumbai and is currently available in Bandra Kurla Complex area. Users can download the smartphone application to avail the service in the city. Mumbai Metropolitan Region Development Authority had already signed an MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, with Yulu Bikes Private Limited to facilitate e-bike services to the commuters visitors to BKC on January 31, 2020. Authorities at the MMRDA were constantly working on ways to address problems arising out of the vehicle traffic in Bandra Kurla Complex. With the new service, the traffic problem is expected to reduce by a significant margin. As a bonus, the adoption of green mobility will also reduce pollution levels in the city. The rental service will provide the last mile connectivity between Bandra and Kurla stations to BKC. The company has placed 18 bike stations in BKC as a part of its pilot implementation of service. The number of bike stations will gradually increase as a part of its demand-based phase-wise expansion across the city at a later date. Users looking to avail the rental service will be paying Rs 5 towards unlocking the bike and then Rs 1.5 for every 1 minute of the ride. In addition to this, the company is also offering monthly recharge options and bonuses ranging between 20 and 100%. The company has stated that it will sanitize the e-bikes frequently and will take sufficient care of the allied facilities. This will address the concerns regarding the safe use of these electric bikes during the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. MMRDA appeals to the commuters to take advantage of this facility and make cycling within BKC a pleasant experience. Electric bike rental service such as Yulu will help people in the area for last mile connectivity and short trips for groceries, among others. This will also help in faster adoption of EVs in the country, which will help decrease the concerning pollution in the country.
The SUV market in India is getting competitive every month with some new entrants in the segment. Tata Motors has introduced a new XT Plus variant to its flagship Harrier SUV in the Indian market. The Tata Harrier SUV manual modes receive new XT Plus variant priced at Rs 16.99 lakh ex-showroom. The company announced that the pricing is only introductory and will be revised starting from October 1, 2020. This initial pricing will be valid for all customers who book the vehicle in September 2020 and take their deliveries by 31st December 2020. Tata Motors also announced that the introductory price is being offered to celebrate the extremely positive response received for Harrier BS6 model in the country. With a month-on-month consistent growth, the Harrier has achieved its highest sales number in 15 months in July 2020. The highlighted feature of the Tata Harrier XT Plus variant is the panoramic sunroof that features in couple of brand's automated features. This includes global close for automatic closing after the SUV is parked. It also features anti-pinch and rain-sensing closure for additional safety. The glass is tinted with a blind cover that ensures a serene in-cabin experience when it's too sunny outside. The XT Plus variant also comes equipped with a host of other features like the projector headlamps, dual function LED DRL, 17-inch alloy wheels, 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system with 8 speakers, 4 speakers plus 4 tweeters, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay connectivity. It also features a push-button start, fully automatic climate control. Safety features on the new variant include a reverse parking camera, auto headlamps, rain-sensing wipers, dual front airbags, and advanced ESP function, among others. Speaking about the powertrain, the Harrier XT Plus continues to feature a 2.0-liter Cryotech diesel engine. It produces 168 bhp and 350 nm of torque, paired to a standard 6-speed manual gearbox. The Harrier is also offered with an optional 6-speed torque converter automatic on other variants in the SUV's lineup. Tata Motors has added a new mid-spec variant with a panoramic sunroof catering to the current trend in the country. Additionally, the Harrier XT Plus is offered with limited time special pricing to celebrate the SUV's success in the market. MG Motors is all set to launch its most awaited premium SUV, MG Gloster, in the Indian market. It will be arriving during Diwali festival in the Indian market. The Gloster will be placed in the premium luxury SUV segment and will be the brand's flagship model. The Gloster SUV will be powered by a 2.0-liter twin-turbo diesel engine producing 215 bhp and 480 nm of torque. The engine comes mated to an 8-speed torque converter automatic sourced from ZF. It will also be offered with an on-demand 4-wheel drive system. It is also expected to have the brand's terrain response system along with multiple driving modes as well. Along with the twin-turbo diesel engine, the Gloster is offered with a 2.0-liter petrol engine options as well. The turbo petrol engine produces 211 bhp and 350 nm of torque. It comes mated to either a 6-speed manual or 6-speed automatic gearbox. However, the company will not be bringing the petrol engine with the Indian spec models during the time of launch. The upcoming Gloster SUV was revealed at the 2020 Auto Expo ahead of its launch in the Indian markets. It is based on the Maxus D90 SUV, which is sold in the international markets. The company recently released a teaser video which showcases the Gloster's high-end driver-assisted Level 1 autonomous system. In the teaser video, the driver successfully parks the large Gloster SUV using the Auto Park Assist with very little effort. The Gloster will feature the brand's advanced driver assistance systems, which was revealed in a teaser video recently. This will include active and passive safety features such as parking assist, auto braking, collision avoidance system, and more. The Gloster will be peppered with a host of features. This includes a 12.3-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and the brand's latest iSmart connected technology with enhanced AI assistance and added number of voice commands to operate various features of the car. It will also feature a panoramic sunroof, keyless entry, dual zone climate control, ventilated seats, wireless charging, multiple airbags, a 360 camera with blind spot monitoring, cruise control, hill start assist, hill descent control, ABS, EBD and lane change assist, among others. It could arrive in a single 7-seater configuration. The MG Gloster feature body-on-frame architecture, much like Ford Endeavor, Toyota Fortuner and the Mahindra Altura G4. Honda Cars India are offering attractive benefits during the ongoing festive season in India. The latest offers include cash discounts, exchange benefits, and other special packages available on select models in the brand's lineup. The models covered under the offer include the Amaze, the WRV, and the Civic. Maximum benefits of up to Rs 2.5 lakh are being offered depending on the model and variant. The discount offers are valid for purchases made online or at any of the authorized dealerships across India. The limited time offers are valid on purchases made between September 1st to September 30th, 2020. Starting with the model-wise offer details, the brand's compact sedan Honda Amaze is being offered with benefits of up to Rs 27,000 across all variants. Customers who are looking to exchange their old car for a new Amaze are offered an extended warranty package for the 4th and 5th year worth Rs 12,000. Additionally, they receive an exchange bonus of Rs 15,000. Moving to the brand's compact SUV, the WRV was recently updated to BS6 standards. It is being offered with both petrol and diesel engine option with the manual gearbox as standard. The WRV is being offered with a cash discount of Rs 20,000 across all trims. Honda is offering the WRV in a total of 4 variants. Prices for the SUV starts from Rs 8.49 lakh and goes all the way up to Rs 10.99 lakh for the top spec diesel trim. All prices mentioned are ex-showroom. The Honda Civic recently received a new update from the company in the form of a new BS6 diesel engine. The diesel model of the Civic attracts the highest benefits this month. Honda is offering a cash discount of up to Rs 2.5 lakh on the diesel variant.
while the petrol-powered model is offered with cash discounts of up to Rs 1 lakh. Other models such as the Jazz, Old and New Generation City and the brand's flagship model, the CR-V, misses out on discount offers this month. Honda recently announced that it will continue to sell the 4th generation City alongside the new generation model in the Indian market. The old generation City is also available in couple of trim levels.
MG Motors India has announced the launch of its special anniversary edition Hector SUV in the Indian market. The new MG Hector Anniversary Edition SUV is offered in both petrol and diesel engine options, with a price tag of Rs 13.63 lakh and Rs 14.99 lakh respectively. All prices are ex-showroom Delhi. The new MG Hector Anniversary Edition is based on the SUV's Super Trim. It carries forward all the features and equipment from the standard variant in the model's lineup. Along with the standard list of equipment, the Anniversary Edition also features a few new ones as well. Some of the new features available on the Anniversary Edition include a 10.3-inch HD touchscreen infotainment display, wireless charging, air purifier and a mud kin kit to sterilize the interiors of the SUV. The MG Hector Anniversary Edition is powered by a 1.5-liter turbo petrol engine producing 140 bhp and 250 nm of peak torque. There is also a 2.0-liter diesel engine which churns out 173 bhp and 350 nm of torque. Both engines are mated to a standard 6-speed manual gearbox. The MG Hector Anniversary Edition remains identical to the standard super variant. The car also doesn't seem to feature any other exterior cosmetic changes as well to help differentiate it from the standard. The four new features added on to the Anniversary Edition are free of charge for customers, as the standard super variant of the Hector is priced the same as well. The Super Trim on the MG Hector is the lower mid-spec variant. The SUV is also offered in three other variants: Style, Smart and Sharp. The MG Hector has been doing well in the Indian market month on month. The company currently has three models in the Indian market, including the Hector, ZS EV and the Hector Plus. The company is now working on introducing its fourth model in the form of the Gloster Premium SUV. The MG Hector Anniversary Edition model celebrates the brand's 1 year of sales in the Indian market. The Hector was the brand's first product in the Indian market, which instantly became popular, receiving an extremely positive response. The MG Hector in India rivals with the likes of the Kia Seltos, Jeep Compass, Tata Harrier, Mahindra XUV500 and the Hyundai Creta. Kawasaki India is upgrading its portfolio to BS6. Recently, they launched 2021 Kawasaki Vulcan BS6, and now Kawasaki India has launched the 2021 Z900 BS6 Superbike in the market. The new Kawasaki Z900 BS6 model is offered with a price tag of Rs 7.99 lakh ex-showroom Delhi. This is a premium of Rs 29,000 compared to the motorcycle's previous BS4 model. The new Kawasaki Z900 motorcycle carries forward a BS6 compliant version of the same 948cc inline 4-cylinder liquid-cooled engine. The updated engine continues to produce identical power and torque figures as its previous BS4 iteration. This translates to 123 bhp at 9500 rpm and 98.6 nm of peak torque at 7700 rpm, paired with a 6-speed gearbox. Apart from the updated engine on the Z900, Kawasaki has also added a host of features, electronic aids and equipment on the new BS6 motorcycle. Some of these new features include LED headlamps, new 4.3-inch TFT instrument cluster with smartphone connectivity via Bluetooth. The motorcycle can also be paired with the smartphone via the brand's dedicated radiology as well. Other features on the 2021 Kawasaki Z900 BS6 include 4 riding modes: road, rain, manual and sport, 2 power modes and 3 level traction control system as well. The new Z900 also comes with updated ergonomics, improved suspension settings and rides on Dunlop Sportsmax Road Sport 2 tires. Braking on the superbike is handled by dual 300mm disc at the front and a single 250mm disc at the rear, supported by dual channel ABS. The motorcycle weighs in at 212 kg curb weight and comes with a fuel tank capacity of 17 liters. Seat height on the motorcycle is at 820mm. The new Kawasaki Z900 BS6 model is now available in all dealerships across the country. Bookings can be made at company dealerships, with deliveries for the same set to begin soon. The motorcycle is available to customers in a choice of 2 color options: metallic graphite grey and candy lime green. The Kawasaki Z900 in India has been priced competitively and rivals with the likes of the Triumph Street Triple R, KTM 790 Duke and the BMW F900R.